Look, I think we've got to do what it takes to get this bill done.
So you would say, don't do it.
If that's what it takes, you know, we've been making this promise for a long time. Obamacare hasn't gotten better. It is failing, and we owe it to the American people to fix this.
But we read things, all of us, yeah, obviously. Yeah. And for some reason, the perception is that the moderate Republicans and the conservative Republicans in the Senate, that the rift has been widening in recent weeks.
Yeah, I mean, I'll grant you it looks a little bit that way over the course of this last week. But we get back into town tonight, and we meet among ourselves actually a couple of times a day, typically, to try to get there. There's a path to bringing the moderates on board. Look, they want more spending, more government spending. There is money in the way this bill was scored that makes that possible. Conservatives want less regulation so the premiums can come down more in the individual market. And there's a group of us that want to make sure we hold on to the reforms to Medicaid that will actually make this program sustainable, which it's not now. I think there's still a path. I'm not Pollyannish about this. It's very, very difficult when you can only lose two votes, and there may already be two that are irretrievable. We're in a tight spot, but we've got to give this every effort.
Can I just ask which two you think are irretrievable? Because those names change pretty
much. I don't really want to say that, but I think we're down to the point where we can't lose anyone.
I saw a great piece in the Weekend Wall Street Journal about Kasich and the way he has, you know, he's a Medicaid guy because the state took Medicaid, but then he put in some reforms to the way the other states would do under the Republican plan that really worked. It held down the but then he's ignoring, for political reasons or for whatever, he's ignoring the progress that he made reform. He wants to reform entitlements, but then with Medicaid, suddenly he's acting like anything that you do is
well, when he was the chairman of the budget committee, he advocated exactly the architectural reform that we have in place. And we do limit the rate at which the program can grow in the future. In recent years, Medicaid per beneficiary spending in Ohio has been well below what we allow the growth to be at. But Joe, you know, this program is unsustainable. It's out of control. It's growing at 6, 7, 8% per year, and nothing can grow faster than the economy.
But it's all about public opinion, and
we've got to bend that.
But Senator, if that's at 50, if Obamacare is now above 50%, and the Republicans' plan is below 20%, it doesn't matter if you keep saying that it's
well, except that it's been wildly mischaracterized. Someone's got to come out and describe what it actually does. The fact that we don't throw anybody off Medicaid, the fact that we just begin to curb the rate at which it grows, the fact that it would make a huge improvement in our fiscal outlook. I think if we actually pass this and people start to read more and more about it, they're going to realize.
Let me ask you this. Can you respond to this just real quick? This is a Republican lobbyist who is for the bill, says this in Axios. The health plan has never been tied to the health of individuals. Abstract arguments about the policy value or ideological purity of legislation rarely work in the Senate. Concrete political ends are needed to create action.
It's a great point, right? I mean, what the Democrats do so well is they'll take any failing program, but they will then find or invent a sympathetic person who benefits from it, and therefore it must be continued in perpetuity. Republicans will make an argument about how, well, this is inefficient, this doesn't cost much, this is unsustainable. Personalizing it makes it much easier to sell, and we don't do such a great job of it.